3. Note commendations on Lieutenant Kelso and the engineering staff. In orbit above us, the engines of the Enterprise are almost fully regenerated. Balance of the landing party is being transported back up. Mitchell, whatever he's become, keeps changing, growing stronger by the minute.
He's been like that for hours now.
Have Dr. Piper meet us in the control room with Kelso. We'll all transport up together.
If he should try to stop us.
Kelso will be on the destruct button until the last minute. I think he knows that.
I'm staying behind with him.
Now, Fission Chamber 3 checks out. Station seems to be running fine.
You're a talented thief, Kelso. Everything you sent up seems to be fitting in place.
I'm kind of proud of the job we've done. Are we going to be ready to transform up?
You're leaving with the ship, Doctor.
He is not evil.
I gave you an order, Doctor.
You should have killed me while you could, James. Command and compassion is a fool's mixture.
Whatever it was. Kelso is dead, strangled. At least Spock's alive.
Dr. Daner?
She'd went with Mitchell.
Don't give him a pill until after I'm gone. My fault. Mitchell got as far as he did. Did you see their direction?
Yes, there was some morning light. They were headed across the valley to the left of the pointed peaks. There's flat land beyond.
When Mr. Spock recovers, you'll both transport up immediately to the Enterprise.
But Captain...
Where, if you have not received a signal from me within 12 hours, you'll proceed at maximum warp to the nearest Earth base with my recommendation. This entire planet be subjected to a lethal concentration of neutron radiation. No protest on this, Mark. That's an order.